This is a subject that has been discussed heavily in journalism circles for almost 30 years. When I came to the American, the one thing that the American lacked was good photojournalism. Minority newspapers have always been welcome writers, but not on the photo side. So when I came to the publication in 82, we had a conversation about trying to increase our coverage photographically, which was a problem for us because of a lack of resources and the fact that the city had an abundance of minority photographers, but no photojournalists. So the issue came up just about how much could I really do by myself? Because again, resources were an issue.
Yeah, can I keep it up?
So I decided to just go out on my own. The only other minority photojournalists I knew were the Post-Dispatch. I really didn't know them that well at the time. So I kind of learned just by trial and error. I was at the American 2 or 3 months before I got hired by the Associated Press, which I didn't know at the time was a blessing for me because it increased my talent level. And it also allowed me to focus in on what was really necessary to get the job done. And that basically boiled down to working all day long. It just did. And so I went out and did that. It wasn't successful. It's one thing to try to pictorialize the African American community. It's another thing when they don't give you permission to. The African American community is very suspect of everyone, including themselves. And a lot of times I had good imagery, but they did not want to be in the paper. And you know, when you're shooting candid photography, you have to remember that you are shooting on the fly. And when once you do that, you go up and you normally ask the person after you introduce yourself, do you mind being in the publication? And back in those days, a lot of times they told me no. So you can actually run a picture, but I don't like to do that. If a person doesn't want to be in the paper, I like to honor that request and not place them in the publication, no matter how good the picture may be. I just think that in the long run, you build a much stronger trust between you and the general public. And that's basically what this boils down to. The public needs to trust you. So it's taken me almost 25 of my 30 years to get the public to allow me to do my job and do it well. And it's come through just time. After 25 years, the people are tired of looking at me and they just let me do whatever I want. it's helped me out greatly. It's brought a different perspective to the African American community because the general public sees in the American what they see in the Post-Dispatch or any other daily paper. Just recently, back in October, during the primaries, I ran into J.B. Forrest of the Post-Dispatch over at Lacey Clay's victory party at the Gateway Classic. He walked right up to me and he said to me, you know, because of you, we have this great mandate now to fulfill. And I said, what mandate is that? He said, they're asking us to give about diversity in our images. I looked at Michael Mason and I said, we had this conversation 25 years ago. And you're just getting to this? He said, there are really honest now about showing diversity in our photographs. And right now, we're very lucky in the process of it all because of social media. The world is used to looking at people of color now because of social media. There is so much of it out there. I mean, at a tremendous rate. If you think Facebook needs to upgrade to process everything that you put on it, the upgrade is to handle the photography. Photography takes up a lot of space in the internet. Those files are huge, more than you can possibly imagine. And now that the general public is into the social media, it's also garnished social acceptance for the African American community. And this has been a long time in coming. I think the African American community has often waited for major media to show us in a positive light. And it's taken this long to actually get it done. The entire community now is diversity friendly. Now when I get freelance jobs, fellas will say to me, you know, and if you can get some minorities in the pictures, that's great. And I always think to myself, I was gonna do that anyway. I went back in the early 80s when I was doing freelance work with people like myself and places like that, and I was a worshiper. I showed them my gardens where they thought they weren't, and they were like, well, where's the shot? The guy was standing right there. And so often, I have looked in the Post-Dispatch and see that they've got people that are not of color, and we were there in large numbers. I'll tell you another example. About 2 years ago, when John Kerry was running for president, he came to New Northside Baptist Church, which is in the heart of the African American community. And you know, we're shooting, everything is fine. And the next day, we had a Post-Dispatch. And the photographer somehow, in an all-black church, found a white child and had John Kerry receiving a flower on the child. I'm like, wait a minute, how did she do this? I mean, I never saw the kid. And he found that person. And the public called, wanting to know why he didn't have a black child, which is what I wanted to do. But sometimes it's not professionally correct. And they didn't really have an excuse for it, except for the fact that I was told that the photographer that they sent was new. So, you know, it's been interesting, particularly in St. Louis. St. Louis is known to have a race problem. I think our race problem is no different than the rest of the country. I know a lot of people outside of my race that love me. I know they do. I think that we have a disconnect between mass media and the general public. And the fact that I think right about now, the general public is talking about diversity. Because the entire planet is now. The one thing that I dislike most about my job is going on diversity. Because I keep saying to myself, I thought we took care of this in the late 50s and early 60s. And here it is, 2012, we're still doing diversity shows. And major companies love the fact that they have somebody of diversity in a great position. Look, here's our person. Come to the store. And this person just got here last week. We've been preparing to beat this problem up for 100 years now. But again, it is a mindset in our culture that is finally changing. And again, it's long overdue. We all want to be seen as one big happy family, and that can be done, but cultures don't change overnight. It takes a minute. When I came to America in 1982, I thought the paper would be successful within 5 years. And 5 years later, we weren't even close. I'd say by 1988, we were still wondering if we were going to stay open. It takes time to change your culture. And if you think it takes time to change your culture inside your job, imagine trying to change your culture of an entire society. It's not going to happen overnight. And people say, well, you know, slavery was a long time ago. I'm like, not really. In the space of time, slavery was last weekend. It takes a long, long time. And it takes all of us to buy into this. If you truly want your children to grow up in an open environment where color is not an issue, you need to train them at birth and let them know that we are all the same. We all go to work every day. We all enjoy our families at work. And we all live open, free, and happy lives. And the media needs to jump on board with that. We are extremely late. And it takes people like yourselves to let them know that. You need to write letters, call, particularly when you're at an event and you see a lot of diversity, and when you look at the paper and you don't see it, you need to make that call. Believe me, they pay attention. They will give you whatever you want because they need your quarters. And that needs to be looked at seriously. That if you really want a change in your publication and you want to see more diversity, that's what needs to be done. And it's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. I'm looking out here at all of you folks. Everybody here is a friend to each other, and particularly in this room. Whatever prejudice you have, I hope we're left at the door. Because in here, we're all the same. We really are. And it's important that you know that. Very, very important. So I have to say this to you in closing, that the media will start to make that very slow turn toward an open environment for diversity in the images. And it's going to get done faster if you help. If you don't help, the voyage to that position will be slow and tedious. And things will happen that will turn us against each other. And we need to take this very, very seriously. So I thank you very much for listening.